I do admit that performance was terrific, but my life isn't fair, you know? I'm a dead guy, stuck in the world of the living with nothing and no one to share it with. But here's the good news. I found a way to make everyone see me, and all I gotta do is get a living person to say my name 3 times, and I've got a plan. I see that tiny little house up there?
Well, it's a lot bigger on the inside.
And the people who live there? I've been watching them for a while now. And finally, they're about to die. They're gonna be my new best friends.
Barbara, I'm home.
Adam and Barbara Maitland.
Was there traffic on the bridge?
That guy Bill was on his tractor, and I was like, pick a lane, Bill.
Isn't this amazing? It's the last day of their lives, and this is what they're talking about.
So, crazy story. I got all the way to Howard's store, and Howard told me they're out of stock.
Oh, no.
So I asked Howard Jr. to check in the back for me.
Smart.
And long story short, I got the last bottle of Manchurian tongue oil.
You see, kids, this is all life is. It's just a bunch of Howards and then you die.
I'll get it.
Oh, they're both gonna go and get it. It's gonna be great. It's gonna be so funny.
Hey, old girl, let's get you finished.
Finished? But Adam, we're just getting started.
Look at this crib, in all of its glorious antiquery. Every curve and surface speaks to me, saying pamper and spoil me, Sammy, annoil me, come on. I know to the untrained eye it's boring, but nothing's a chore when you're restoring. Apart from frustration, pain, and financial drain, it's fun. Folks say, Adam, why do you polish your crib when you don't have a kid? And even if you did have a kid, this crib is your best is replacing a baby inside it, so it simply exists to remind you your sense of perfection is just a reflection that you are not mentally prepared to make room for a kid. Adam, why don't you live, Adam? Just make a start. Are you willing to take the next step? Ready, set, ready, set.
That was the O'Briens calling.
Oh, don't worry, I'll have this crib ready before the baby gets here.
She had it yesterday.
Oh, great. Then I guess there's no rush.
Make me a sandwich?
One sandwich coming up.
Spoiler alert, she's never gonna eat that sandwich.
Look at these jugs! Amazingly glazed and terracottery. I took some clay and made you pottery. The world will never wreck you, I'll protect you in a mother's embrace. Folks say, Barbara, why can't you see that ceramics is simply a manifestation of motherly panic? By making a baby that's breakable, aren't you creating a way of translating the terror of making maternal mistakes into clay, hiding away the fact that you don't face being my mom? Barbara, that's what you've done. Barbara, just make a start. Are you willing to take the next step? Ready, set. Here we stand at the end of a 10-year plan. A house, a yard, a minivan, a baby should be next. Together let's leap off the cliff, fall forever then smash to bits. Trapped in a terrifying viper pit of diapers and regrets. Are we willing to take the next step?
Ready, set.
Ready, set.
Not yet.
Not yet.
Why rush?
Why rush? Soon enough our hopes and our dreams will be crushed, but not yet.
Not yet.
Not now.
Not now. Oh, no. See, we can't start a family in a house with creaky floorboards.
You are absolutely right. Let's add it to the list with the cracks in the plaster.
The Wi-Fi should be faster.
This sofa needs a caster.
The bathroom's a disaster.
What about global poverty?
What about world peace?
And there's the whole darn economy.
The whole Middle East.
We should learn Mandarin.
Yeah, or Spanish at least.
No habla español. Don't serve it as por favor. And that's all we got, and that's not a lot. Do we want a bilingual household or not? So let's go slow, no breaking a sweat. What's the point of having children if we're drowning in debt? And we're totally,
completely,
maybe 80%.
I say 78.
Ready to take the next step.
Yeah.
The next step.
Zoom, bow, wow.
The next step.
Zee, bee, 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 bee.
outlet.
See, I wasn't kidding, it's a show about death.